Hello and welcome to another edition of Press the Action Button Podcast. As always, I am your host, Joystick. Why is my mic so quiet, I wonder?
It doesn't really look like it is.
Okay, maybe. Hopefully it's not. Anyway.
That's a respectable-looking waveform.
Anyway, with me this week,
on our television monitor.
Coming back, maybe permanently, we hope, is...
And Ronald McFreaking Donald.
Tell the people how you are, D-Pad.
I'm doing pretty good. Yeah, it looks like my wavelength is about the same size as your wavelength.
Yeah. Well, it's just
I see your Schwartz is as big as mine.
It was a little bit smaller, just a little bit there, so it kind of concerned me like that. See, that's kind of small, but I don't know, maybe...
It's how small.
Hopefully it'll
look at us, a bunch of nerds bragging about the sizes of our own wavelengths.
Yeah. The bigger your wavelength is, the bigger your e-penis.
Your e-penis.
Your e-penis.
Enus?
Yeah.
Your
you want to say hi to the people because you're always here yeah. with me, GamePace?
Yeah, I was at the game night with my parents and my aunt and uncle earlier. They were watching the Steelers versus, what were they playing, the Jets?
The Jets.
But Benny and the Jets. And
the Steelers wound up winning.
We had this sweet Western Pennsylvania fan, yeah. And, there was this big, great big platter of, like, cocktail weenies wrapped in, like, puff pastry. And my dad's like, all right, I step in front of my dad to grab one. And my dad's like, all right, Alex, if you want to get in the way and grab a weenie there. And my Uncle Sam goes, that's what she said. I was like, what?
That's funny.
That doesn't even make sense. I'm just astonished to hear that, you know, he's like 50.
Yeah, it would kind of be the other way around. Yeah. I forget what it was my dad said. My dad said something about grabbing a weenie. And my uncle's like, that's what Marianne says. Or that's what I said to... you know.
She would never say that.
This sounds like
grab,
my...
Grab a weenie?
Jeez, that sounds like my boss.
Your boss
my
does?
Boss,
that's what she said, Jules?
My boss who said, I'm so horny, I'd hump the crack of dawn. Who says that?
Is your boss like Steve Carell from The Office?
No, my boss is like freaking... Like... I can't even... It's such like a like an awful sense of humor, I can't even describe it.
I don't know. You know what we did yesterday, though? We went to see True Grit.
My boss is like the grandfather from Little Miss Sunshine. Almost. He's not that old, but...
Really? He's hateful like that? And disgruntled and addicted to heroin?
Yes. No, he's just very crude and very like bitter and cynical, but in a funny way.
Alright, I don't think the grandfather on the Little Miss Sunshine was trying to be funny at any point in that movie.
No.
I think that's why he's funny. But...
he's a funny
Steve Carell was in
Oh, that's
Little
a good
Miss
movie!
Sunshine too.
So I've heard.
That's what we were...
I haven't seen it, though.
Not Steve Carell, he wasn't the grandfather.
No.
Yeah, we went to see True Grit yesterday. That movie was actually pretty good. I really enjoyed it.
It was the sweet...
Makes me want to go back and watch the original True Grit, though, the one
that,
with John Wayne.
That now makes a total of four movies in which, Jeff Bridges doesn't play the dude.
Yeah, but he still
kinda
a little
does.
Bit, he still
A little bit. Like in the
I didn't see
Tron.
The dude in his character at all in this one. But I've heard that he's
so
very dudish in Tron, though.
So you were hiding with the gun. I was hiding with the gun. Loaded and cocked. Well, you don't load it and cock it, the gun doesn't fire.
Gun don't shoot. That's a good movie. I highly recommend getting off your asses and going to see it.
He throws like this little like Native American like teenage and Native American kid on his face in the dirt like three times in a row. And they don't say anything about it. He's just like, oh, my work here's done.
Wait, what was that?
Yeah, sure.
You want to announce what we're drinking?
We are drinking Heineken.
Heineken.
Heineken! Pabst Blue Ribbon! We're actually drinking Pabst Blue Ribbon.
Yeah, we are drinking Pabst Blue Ribbon. Pop the top.
Yep. Right,
here we go.
That was the most drawn out pop popping ever.
I had to act mine out because I didn't.
The splashing sensation in the back of your throat, as Game Face put it once. There it is. And this week you will be getting more of the soundtrack. You probably already listened to it, but you will be getting more of the sweet soundtrack from Brutal Legend. We will go through that until we are done, which means we will be next, like, 5 podcasts will have Brutal Legend.
There ain't nothing wrong with that.
No, there's not. Because you know why? Because it's damn good music. That's why. Yeah. I mean, there's like 2 or 3 tracks from it that I'm going to skip. I'll skip Cabbage Boy because it's intentionally horrible.
Oh, I'd throw it in there, right?
Yeah, put it in there. It's not like people are paying
like right at this point while I'm talking, just have it like fade into Cabbage Boy just for like maybe 15 seconds.
The whole podcast pauses mid-sentence like I did that one time.
Oh, with the intermission.
Yeah, I got some like elevator music and used that for an intermission in the middle of one of our podcasts, and it was the only thing playing. There was no sound, there was no talking, just the intermission music, and then it continued.
Yeah, right, kind of like that Justin Bieber gets squished 52 times.
Bieber, yeah, he Bieber, did get squished 52 Bieber. Times. Did you see the thing I posted on your Facebook?
Post it on your
face.
Oh,
with Brental Floss singing with the Megas.
Yes, Floss and the Megas. That was fucking awesome, wasn't it?
The Megas. I actually checked to see if they're going on tour. They're not. Neither is MC Chris. And that's
the story. I just dumped beer all over the floor.
I didn't. Until I saw that video. Yeah.
I just dumped...
Yeah, that was a sweet video, though.
Oh, my gosh, yeah.
I just dumped beer all over the floor trying to pull
a duet there for a minute.
On the, it was, I Want to Be the One and Gotta Run. Mega Man 2. It's fucking sweet.
Yeah.
Look it up on Brental Floss's channel. Just look up Brental Floss and then Megas and you'll find it. It's pretty sweet. Although, I like your mustache.
So, first in line news is, our 2-year-old roommate. Actually, our 35-year-old roommate's 2-year-old son poured perfect beer into a glass today without us watching. It was scary, but it's very stupid and like drama on the show. And
yeah, I thought honestly, that's what I thought you were going to get into there.
But basically,
they
folks
don't need to know that.
Basically, folks, my roommate told me that he was getting a ride home from work, so I went and ran out to the pub with my old coworker / friend from high school, the Billy Wrigley, aka what's his name on the show?
Not so silent protagonist.
The silent protagonist, and I ran out there, and we were there for about a half an hour, and then I came home, ran to. My roommate's baby mama's house, and picked up the kid and brought him back here, expecting Paul to be here, and he wasn't, because apparently when he gets a ride from his dishwasher, he has to wait like an extra 2 hours for his dishwasher to get off work. I forgot that, so I was sitting around. Well, yeah, that's true. But I was watching the kid for 2 hours, and in the he managed to find a half-open beer and pour it perfect into a glass. I'm proud of that kid.
That was funny.
It was
kind of
fun. Yeah. And then Dean died.
And then Jake died. We can brag about his beer pouring abilities. That's not going to come into play until he's in college, you know. But one thing that I was surprised is that he can put in a DVD, open the tray, close it, and start a movie up. And he can unplug the RCA cables out of the back of a TV and plug them back in the right order.
This kid just turned 2, and he knows video technology.
Oh man, you better bring him up to be a gamer, man.
Well, hey, remember? Well, he can say he can go game. He was the other day. He couldn't really get his mind around the weird looking D-pad because he's used to a joystick.
Hey,
but, what?
Find that offensive.
Yeah, D-pad, you're weird looking.
I'm 4 directions. I'm not complicated. Hey, look at that joystick over here. He doesn't know which way he's going. True. He doesn't. Is he kind of up or is he kind of left or is he up left? You don't know with joystick.
Yeah, master system
with me, you know exactly
like
which direction.
It's just like
you're
a
going.
Great
left,
big.
Right, up, down. You don't need anything else.
Exactly.
Left, right, up, down.
Exactly. Hey, why are you defending my position? You should be standing
the,
up for yourself.
The master system, the D-pad on a master system controller is just like
okay.
stamping your thumb on a Reese's
it's
peanut butter
because
cup.
You're Garth to my Wayne. There you go.
I'm gonna put my butt on the wall.
People are starting to say, hey, there goes Garth and his friend Wayne. You know, this is weird.
he's talking about Wayne's World 2.
Yeah, wow. You
caught
on to
him that Jim Morris.
So, what did I have the idea? We should do a skit with,
Yo. What's that from?
Yo.
Like a 91 different Kung Fu movie?
I had the idea we should do a skit with like Tony Stark and Bruce Wayne just doing something completely mundane. Like
this
just like ordering at a diner or something.
This was inspired by a video on the internet.
Like trying to put a dollar into a vending machine but it doesn't seem to want to take it.
This was
something like that.
This was inspired by a thing on the internet called "How Iron Man Should Have Ended." It had Iron Man sitting there talking to Batman and Superman, and he's like, "Then I held a press conference. What'd you do then? Then I held a press conference and told the world that I'm Iron Man. What? You can't do that. You can't just reveal your secret identity. Why not? Because I did, and I'm awesome. So in your face." I could totally picture
Tony Stark
saying that.
Shit. Tony Stark.
I think Tony Stark
is the only non-superhero that could get to hang out with the superheroes.
Yeah.
Well, Batman isn't really a superhero, though. There's
exactly.
nothing super about him. But
yeah, exactly.
Batman's fucking awesome. Though.
No, he's awesome, but he's not a superhero.
You have to have superpowers to be a superhero.
What?
You can't be just anyone.
You can be a hero if you want, but
you
a hero
have to be
is hit, like...
Girl.
Yeah.
You have to be Hit Girl.
Hit Girl can hang out with the superheroes.
Hit Girl's
she's
fucking
rad.
Ass. Big Daddy was pretty cool too.
It was
Nick Cage in a role that he didn't
Cage
overact
as
for once.
Fu Manchu.
Yes, he needs to play Fu Manchu. Should we get to the first topic?
No, because I still was telling my story. So Bruce Wayne and Tony Stark is doing something mundane, like ordering at a diner. It's like vegetable. Yeah. Do you get Harvard Beats here? I'm sorry, we don't have Harvard Beats right now. We just have the Pickwick Beats. I'm Iron Man. I'll see what I can do. Bruce Wayne's just like, look. You gotta... No. Don't do that. Don't do that.
He's like, why not? Because I'm Iron Man. And I'm awesome.
I'm Iron Man.
So in your face.
I
could totally picture him saying that to Batman. I'm awesome. So in your face.
Mm-hmm. We could do a whole series of these. We'd have to have the Tomothy beat Tony Stark, though.
Do you think it was because of Ozzy Osbourne that inspired Tony Stark to come out to everybody? I mean, tell him all that he done. With the famous words.
I am Iron Man?
Yeah.
Because Ozzy said that at the beginning of the song, Iron Man.
Iron Man as a superhero was around before the song, right?
I don't know.
Because the song Iron Man by Ozzy Osbourne doesn't seem to actually... Or Black Sabbath, sorry. Doesn't actually seem to be...
About Iron Man?
Yeah.
Nothing to do with Iron Man.
Okay.
It's not even really a coherent story.
Time and space for the future
of
mankind. He was... Turn to steel in the
right.
great magnetic field.
The lyrics there seem like they would be something that inspires a comic, not the other way around.
Yeah. Do you know that Scott Pilgrim was based on a song by a band called Plumtree called Scott Pilgrim?
Huh.
There's one lyric. There is one line in the song that inspired the whole comic series.
What?
I've liked you for like 1,000 years.
That is a good movie, Scott Pilgrim.
What?
I love Scott Pilgrim.
I'd love to read the graphic novels.
Should we get to
Until
the
then,
topic?
I'm stuck with Warrior!
First topic.
Okay.
Hulk Hogan.
Okay, first topic.
No. Okay, fine.
Your mom.
Shuffle Coon.
Anyway, Duke Nukem Forever. Finally, we got a new trailer this week that kind of made fun of the fact that it's taken 13 years to get this game done. And at the end of the trailer was a fucking release date. That's right, Duke Nukem Forever has a release date. That's hard to believe, isn't it? Because this game was announced in 1997, anyway. May 3rd in North America, May 6th worldwide, it will be coming to the PC, the PlayStation 3, and the Xbox 360 from... Oh, fuck. Now my mind's gone blank. The people who developed Borderlands.
Your mom?
You've seen Borderlands, right?
Yeah, who did that?
Oh. Gearbox Software, that's it. They're doing that, and I trust Gearbox. Gearbox has made a bunch of very, very good games. You know where they're based? Dallas-Fort Worth area, Texas. Woo! Not that I'm proud.
Not that I'm proud or anything.
Anyway, yeah, 13 years in development, dude. 13! That's ridiculous. How the hell did this game take 13 years to make?
StarCraft 2, I don't know, because they knew there would be riots if they did it wrong.
The original Duke Nukem on PC and whatnot was fucking awesome.
This game had better reach out of the screen and get Botox.
And dubs. And girls in the game.
And Blowtox.
There are girls in the game, of course, it's fucking Duke Nukem, there are strippers.
Right.
They better reach out and give you a hand job for making it take so long. Then it'll get Game of the Year. What'd you think?
I don't know, that's kind of the point where it ceases to be a game and starts to be like a...
Girlfriend?
Yeah.
Maybe it may... Except this girlfriend, you can just turn her off and she will quit bitching at you. She's like, just like, shut up, woman. Power down.
Shut down, woman.
Maybe it'll be Skyrim.
Dang, the parts.
My Dilbert book is up there.
Oh, yeah. I was going to put that up there and try and get my printer scanner on top of it, and it looked retarded, so I expanded that plan. I put the printer scanner under the desk instead.
Oh, it's down there. Okay, I was about to ask you where it was. Anyway, I am actually looking forward to this game. And that sounds kind of weird after 13 years of knowing that it's coming and it being an industry joke that it'll never come out, but... I'm kind of excited about this, because I saw the trailer, and I thought it looked pretty sweet. The graphics were nice, it had the same Duke Nukem attitude, and John St. John's voice saying stuff like, I've got balls of steel, and stuff like that.
You got, like, goop in your hair.
I'm an equal opportunity killer. Where?
In the very back. I think you got it.
I didn't see it.
I think you got it.
It's more like varnish.
Dude,
it smells like varnish.
Yeah,
doesn't
it does.
It's weird.
Mm-hmm.
Why would I have varnish in my hair?
Dude, you don't need that shit to like make your hair silky smooth. Like, it's not gonna.
I have no idea why my hair smells like varnish.
What are you going? Are you going for a comb over or something?
Oh, do I look like I need a comb over? I got more hair than you do. You got a lot of hair.
Yeah, I do. I clogged like the shower before I moved out of my old place.
Oh wow! Yeah, I used to do that.
What was
Cookstown.
That? Your final present to Birdman?
It wasn't an intentional present.
I used to do that in college when I had long hair. Hey, remember that picture of our dad when he was in college and he's like. He looks like you with, like, shoulder-length hair, and he's, like, facing forward, but he's looking off to the side, looking, like, pre-emo.
Yeah, that was pretty crazy. Pre-emo.
You should have long hair. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, I'm working on it.
You look badass with long hair.
Did you see my picture? My Jesus pictures?
I saw the one where you look like David Koresh.
What? Who's David Grimm?
He was the leader of the Branch Davidians that died in the 21-day standoff with ETF in Waco, Texas.
Oh, okay.
In the early 90s.
That's why it was Greek theme.
Yeah, so you don't know who the Branch Davidians are or any of that?
No idea. Was that like the Alamo or something?
It was a cult. It was a cult. They had
the Alamo.
It was a cult, and they all lived up at a place called Mount Carmel. And they were supposed to be getting hairpin triggers, which is an illegal weapon modification that makes standard weapons fire automatically. And the ATF got called in on this when they heard about it, and they had a gunfire one day, and then like a 30-day standoff that ended that they were trying to negotiate when they don't know who shot first.
Han Solo.
Yes, Han Solo shot at the Branch Davidians. And then Yoda came in and set the place on fire.
Right.
Actually, that did happen. Somehow, the place got set on fire on accident. And with the wood we made of, it burned in about 10 minutes and everybody died.
Wow. It's a dry climate.
So what's the moral of this story?
Look up Waco Rules of Engagement. It's a very good document. Look that up on YouTube. Waco Rules of Engagement. It'll tell you all about it. Not everything in it is completely accurate, but it's a very, very good and informative documentary about Waco. And it actually won some kind of Emmy Award for documentaries.
I'll check it out.
If you want to know more about it, that's your best bet.
I'll just wait for the movie to come out.
Yeah.
I don't even know if there is
a
movie.
Yeah.
Hard day.
The guy honestly thought he was the reincarnation of Jesus or something.
Books on tape. Everything should be on books on tape.
Isn't it books on CD now?
Yeah, but that's not cool.
Neither is tape.
Tape is awesome.
They should have books on vinyl.
Sweet. They should have books. The coolest thing to release a book on would be like reel-to-reel tape.
Would you buy a book on vinyl?
A book on vinyl?
Yes, a book on vinyl.
If they had a movie on vinyl, even if the vinyl was like fucking the size of as tall as you.
Ooh, they did that. Vinyl video. There's a commercial. They have like an infomercial that's like all in black and white. And it's like all 50s style. And they're like, please call for more information on vinyl video. Please call the number on your screen or visit www.vinylvideo.com. But it's like all like 50s looking.
Oh, what?
Movies on a vinyl record.
What was the thing that was like vinyl was as big as vinyl, but it comes with like a giant CD? Yeah, Laserdisc. That would be the best bet for that. Laserdisc.
No, it has to be vinyl. I want to crank it with my hand.
I don't crank my vinyl with my hand. What are you talking about?
I want it to be like one of those
puppet.
Old...
I fucking just put my thing down on there and I plug it in and it fucking works.
No, I literally want mine to be like steampunkish, like fucking it's like 1920 technology.
I would tell you to start getting
dude, out. This thing, all it is you take like a normal record player, but you just like a 50, like a you just have like a
why is it spazzing out there? Look at that. That was your talking. Maybe it doesn't like you. Okay, you want to talk about Activision? And...
Barely.
Is it they're recording you.
No, that's you.
No, that is where you said barely.
Barely.
See, there it goes.
Hang on.
Barely.
See, there it's recording you.
Wait, it didn't.
Okay, everybody. Okay, everybody, just shut up.
You might have another microphone going.
Say barely.
But you know what? The microphone costs like $3.
For the nozzle.
Either way, it's cheap. Can we move to the second topic, please?
Yes.
Activision is closing down Bizarre Creations, who made Project Gotham Racing, Geometry Wars, and Blur. They are also considering shutting down the Call of Duty Black Ops servers for the PlayStation 3. Are they fucking retarded?
Yeah, they're gonna do riots in the streets and stuff.
Call of Duty has like ravenous fanboys, like fucking Halo.
Yeah, Tim and Sean are two of them.
And it's ridiculous.
And I think the Halo craze kind of died out. It got taken over. Like, it was like Call of Duty and Modern Warfare is a big one.
Halo is not selling as well as Call of Duty right now. But Halo, the latest Halo game actually did sell very, very well. Several, like 3 million copies. On
oh,
game
you mean
one
Halo Reach?
Yeah, Halo Reach.
Yeah, yeah,
it sounds
know.
Like a toothbrush.
Everyone was talking about it for like a month, and then went away. There's that commercial. There was that cartoon. And it's like Halo Reach. And the two people were like,
and then I was like dang,
Halo
no.
Reach, awesome, or something. By the same person who did the
Metal Gear Awesome. Never really was amused by that.
I love Metal Gear Awesome.
Of course, I never really played Metal Gear. Honestly,
I love Metal Gear. Love it, love it, love it. Anyway, fucking, this is so. Closing down Bizarre Creations kind of sucks, even though they largely did racing games, and I'm not into racing games. They were very, very good at it, and most of the games sold pretty well.
Blur was fantastic.
Yeah, that's what I heard. I haven't played Blur, but I heard it was great. So why sell
it's
down some?
It's kind of like XG2. I mean, Game Face. Remember XG2?
XG2.
On the for N64, you're on like these high speed
Extreme G2. Yes, yeah, I do remember Extreme G.
Yeah,
Extreme G2.
You're on these supersonic like.
It's like
Zero
like
X, G-Force
meets motorcycles.
They're motorcycles and there's weapons in them. You can pick up power ups and
like
Brad
Racer.
In the sky.
What
like
the, Racer. What's the tagline for that G-Force meets G-String?
I don't remember seeing commercials for it. I remember playing it.
I remember
we, if you go fast, if you reach a certain speed, you break the sound barrier, and like all the sound.
The volley warp, and the music and all the sound effects just kind of get muted.
Yeah, it sounds like you're underwater, like you just hear. And like all the screen gets blurry, and there's just nothing but you and speed. And
yeah.
we could keep that up.
Blur does that when they get up to a certain.
3 or 4 seconds.
Blur does that when you get up to a certain speed, right?
I don't know. I've never gone that fast in Blur. You're in vehicles. You're in like cars with V8 engines.
But Blur did have a great commercial though, when they were making fun of kart racers and like the kart racers like
Mario racing.
Mario
Kart.
Yeah. And then the little kart racer guy walks over there. And he's like
not
watching.
It's about winning. It's about making friends.
And then he punched him in
Shut
the butt.
Shut the fuck up!
Shut up, Pinky!
Yeah.
It was great.
That's what he said.
But what is really going to piss off the gamers is if they close down the servers for Black Ops. I understand that there are a number of problems with Black Ops on the PlayStation 3 with matchmaking and several other things that they should be able to fix with a patch, and they said they can't do it, which I'm calling bullshit on, by the way. I'm saying, you know what, fucking, if they can fix New Vegas, you can fix this.
They just want to take a week break and just be like,
yep,
basically what it amounts to. I don't think I think Activision just doesn't want to do it.
Yep.
So like, you know what, fuck it. And then they said something about quite possibly closing down the servers. Why the fuck would they close down the servers? I mean, how well did that sell for them for the PlayStation 3? Several million copies. I mean, in the months, every single month that the Xbox 360 version of that game took the number one slot, the PlayStation version of it took the number two slot in overall sales. So it's selling like a million copies a month or whatever on each system. And if you're going to shut down the servers, you're going to lose half of that.
I guess they're wealthy enough that they can take that kind of fall. You know? I think the fans are going to be pissed, but I'm going to just have to deal with it because I'm going to
revolt against them.
These are fans who know how to handle themselves tactically in a gunfight because they're addicts.
I've heard a whole bunch of people saying that they're going to start boycotting. I'm never going to buy an Activision game, which I don't think they could because Blizzard is part of Activision. And I like my Blizzard video games. I need my StarCraft 2. Right?
I haven't really played StarCraft 2 yet. Like, I've seen it being played.
It's fun. It's a lot of fun, but... I can't even believe that they're considering it with how much of a moneymaker that game is for them. It's fucking retarded.
Well, yeah, they already went and made the money, you know. Like, you don't pay monthly for it, do you?
No. There was rumors that they were considering it, which I wouldn't put it past Activision, because it seems like a whole lot of the time lately, they are doing everything within their power to piss off Activision. I mean, how many weeks in a row did we discuss something about Infinity Ward when we first started doing this podcast?
I don't know. One?
We started off at week one, and it lasted 3 or 4 podcasts after that.
Yeah, I remember that.
One story after another about how they were fucking Infinity Ward, and we have further developments on it that we would discuss every week until I was like, you know what? We're fucking done. We're not discussing that anymore. We've discussed it to death. You know? Mm. And it seems like Activision is doing everything within their power to make gamers hate them.
Yep. They're good at it.
Maybe they're like Death Clock. The more they hate their fans, the more their fans love them.
Good analogy.
Fucking one of the fans reached up and touched Murderface, and Murderface like killed
broke his nose.
Yeah,
that was when Murderface was playing a bass riff with his dick. That was incredible.
It was the prince of. It was the prince of Norway or something.
Right, it was a prince
trying to climb up on stage. He's like, whoa, no, bam.
And they had to like make a formal apology in Norway.
In which they summoned an ancient troll
called Mooster
Krakish.
Were
those episodes related?
That was the same episode. It starts off with...
No.
There was another time where Murderface just played the bass guitar with his junk. But then there was another time where he did it. Yes.
That was Murderface's birthday, that episode where he played the guitar with his junk. The one where
he
they awaken the sea troll, like they awaken the troll and then that's it. Like,
yeah, but that started off with him headbutting someone in the head because he was doing that thing and some guy got too close to his junk, so he headbutted him. And it turned out to be the Prince of Norway.
Does Norway even have a prince, I wonder?
Does Norway have a Norway?
Yes, Norway has a Norway.
Norway.
Yeah, freaking Norway.
Norwegian.
Oh, yeah, you took me to the sausage fest. That was good. It was Indiana.
No, Toki, that was a sausage fest. Anyway, I'm saying this place is a sausage fest because there are no women here to touch.
The sausage?
Yes,
Toki. Yes, Toki.
Oh, man. I just remember they had to issue a formal apology to Norway or whatever, and they accidentally summoned a troll called Mooster Krakish.
The Dead Sea Troll.
Godzilla versus Mooster Krakish.
There's only two things you can do during a power outage. Drink.
One thing. Good show. Nice marmot.
Yeah, see, there should be Godzilla versus Mooster Krakish. I would go see that.
Would you go see that, D-Bad?
I'd see Godzilla versus the Death Bone.
Yeah.
Because it cannot seem to handle
and I hate it. Okay. Final Fantasy XIII-2 has been confirmed at a press conference held by Square Enix. It will be released sometime in 2011 in Japan. No United States release date yet. It will star Lightning and Square, said they will take fan complaints into consideration. Considering fan complaints involve just about every single aspect of the game, it
yeah,
might
Final
wind up
Fantasy with, fans. I said this at a bar. I'm not going to say it here.
Go say it.
I said, because Final Fantasy fans suck, so you're going to let them in charge of the fate of the fan of the franchise?
Well,
that's
Final
not
Fantasy,
true. I'm a Final Fantasy fan,
if
sort
Final
of.
Final Fantasy fans want to put exploration back into it and put back player involvement in the fucking battle system so it's actually engaging again, I'm all for it.
I think a lot of Final Fantasy fans like getting raped artistically repeatedly because they don't really care what goes
Kenju.
Into it anymore.
Kenju.
They don't really care what goes into it anymore. As long as it has the logo and chocobos.
Chocobos and black mages are like the only consistency that there's ever been.
And Cid.
And Cid. There's always been a Cid.
There was not chocobos or black mages in Final Fantasy 1.
There were black mages. But no chocobos.
Oh yeah, there were no chocobos. That's it. And there was no Cid.
I thought there was.
Not in 1, there was Cid in 2. Who was the first
Ian played through 1 all the way, just so you know.
So did I.
Sid's the one who builds the airship for you.
Yeah.
You find the airship in 1. You get an airship from 2. It's from Sid in 2.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, there is no Sid in 1.
See, I know
Bahamut.
I'm right.
Bahamut. Bahamut makes
Bahamut
it.
Is in
it. Yeah.
He's like the king of the dragons or something, but he's not a summon. There's no summons in 1. 1 was a damn good game, though. I still really like 1. A lot of Final Fantasy fans underrated, though. I mean, a lot of
No, it's hard. No, it's slow. It's time-consuming. Dude, you gotta look
at, it's the 80s.
Yeah, you gotta think of, like, what that game did for the future of games, you
Most
know?
People
like,
complain that it doesn't have much of a story. I'm like, it had a shitload more...
It takes a while to get to the story. That's the thing.
It had a shitload more story than, like,
it was inspired
anything
by
else on
yeah,
game,
exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. Well,
was it inspired
if you use
by
a little
Dragon
bit
Quest.
Of imagination, that game goes a really long way.
And the Ultima series of the United States.
I was a Final Fantasy fanboy until 10. I mean, including.
So you mean like 7 and 9?
I thought 10 was amazing.
Because we didn't play, we didn't even find
really
6 until after we played through 7.
At it, you know,
I
like
love
really
1, I like 2. I haven't played 3 enough to know if I liked it or not. Because
you mean the Japanese
my
3?
DS, yes, the real 3. Then 4, which is 2 in America, which was 2 in America back in the NES. I fucking love that game.
Yeah, with Cecil.
Yeah, hey, Cecil, the and Cecil Harvey and...
Hey, Ian, do you have a lighter?
I went...
What?
Just wondering.
Cecil Harvey and Kane Highwind, yes. That was such a fucking good game. And then 5 I really liked, and 6 is my all-time favorite.
Yeah, I hear that a lot.
6
is
amazing,
fantastic.
Dude. Fucking Kefka is the greatest villain of all time.
Son of a submariner.
He did say that. That was great. Then 7, not a huge fan of 7. I don't hate it,
but
I don't love it either.
But it was good.
It was decent.
I mean, I'm just very nostalgic about it. It might not be the best Final Fantasy out there, but it was my introduction to the series, and we got that on our dad's old PC and played the crap out of that game.
Yeah,
back when we had time to do stuff.
Yeah, I miss those days.
Back when I could
I beat
my homework
Emerald
in 2
Weapon
hours and just sit around.
Before I ever beat Sephiroth.
Then Final Fantasy 8. Fuck Final Fantasy.
Yeah, yeah.
Fuck
that's
it.
That's what I hear.
I
hear there's not
game.
Any fantasy. I hear it's all technical. It's all like...
It's like
realism.
Modern and science fiction material.
There's a little bit of there's magic.
Well,
there's
a whole
magic,
lot of modern science
system
fiction in 7,
sucks.
Too. I mean, 7's plot revolves around 8.
What?
Genova. Is an alien.
Yeah, but Final Fantasy VII is like...
No, she's not an angel. She's an alien.
Final Fantasy VII is like...
Ancients come from?
Magic
part of the
and
aliens?
A sci-fi and a sort of steampunk And it's
8 was kind of steampunk. 7 was kind of steampunk.
7 was really 9 steampunk.
I love 9. 9's a masterpiece.
I haven't played very much of 9. I played a little bit of it, and I liked it, but...
I love Spoonie's reason that he refuses to play 9, remember?
I forget.
But he was bitching about how Zidane had a tail.
Oh, yeah.
So he refused to play it because it reminded him of furries.
Yeah, he did say that.
Oh, that was great.
Well, he had like 3 reasons, but that was like the second one.
But I really liked 9, and then 10 I thought was a mixed bag. 10 too can rot in hell. I didn't play 11 because it's the online one, and I don't really care about MMOs.
I played up until... I played maybe about 5 hours into 10, and then I said, you know, I really don't care what happens next. So I stopped playing.
Then 12...
Yeah, you gotta roll with it. That's what I'm saying. Like, you gotta play through it and then look back on it. It's, I don't know. But just the way they ended it, the whole way the game plays.
I was happy because Titus disappeared.
And he doesn't disappear, it's the world that disappears.
You've got to see
Spoonie did a 4-part review that's about an hour long where he tore apart Final Fantasy X. It's great.
Okay, you know at the end where you played through it again?
Yeah.
Do you remember at the end when they tried to like summon Sin by playing music? Or something?
When they
attract Sin?
Or two.
When they were trying to draw Sin out by having the entire world join together and singing Sin's favorite song. Or Jet's favorite song, which is like the dumbest plan of all time, but it actually worked.
Right.
Well,
right.
When Spoonie was covering that, he goes, yeah, that's right. They're going to lure Sin out by playing his favorite song. And he plays like the cutscene, and over top of it, you hear, if you like piña coladas.
I always kind of pictured Jet as a Jimmy Buffett fan.
Cheeseburger in paradise. Paradise! It's funny.
Anyway, 12 is probably my favorite since the 2D days. 12 is probably my favorite Final Fantasy.
It's a bold statement.
Since 6. I loved 12. I loved everything about 12. 13, I'm hating with a passion. 13, I'll probably play through, and then I'll play through it again just to capture footage of it, and then I will post a hour-plus-long rant online about why I hate this game.
And then issue a fatwa on it?
I will spoonie that game. I will spoonie that game.
You're gonna spoon Snow?
Fuck Snow, he's a fucking retard. The guy's dumb as hell.
Titus is pretty dumb, right?
Titus sucks.
When the Final Fantasy 13 first came out and I first played it, I put up on Twitter, I said, Final Fantasy 13 is... Well, at least Titus isn't in it. I would actually probably prefer 13 over 10. I didn't hate 10. I just wasn't crazy about it. 13, I didn't hate either. I actually found it kind of interesting. Worth picking up, at least. But not spectacular. Not great.
I'll tell you what. Playing through 12. If only because I think it actually has a worthwhile Cloud.
No, he wasn't a character at all. I guess he was just there for you.
Zack has a personality, though. Zack has like a personality, and he's not like a typical emo, whiny little
Cloud Strife, at the very least, has a rudimentary character arc in which he's very indifferent, he's only in it for the money, and then he kind of slowly starts to care.
That's about it.
But, you know, even that's... In his defense, you know, in Final Fantasy's defense, that's still more personality than Chrono ever had.
Or Link.
Have you played...
And somehow I cared more about Chrono than I did about Cloud.
I didn't give a crap about Chrono because he never said anything. You don't... It's like, Chrono's missing! You know, there's that token part in, like, the old RPGs where the main character goes missing.
Right, you gotta play
that happened
somehow.
To Chrono, and I was like... I don't care. Just let me continue in the game.
That happens in 7 also.
Yeah.
You gotta play.
And I cared more about Cloud than I did about Chrono. I loved Chrono Trigger. D-pad, have you, how much of that game have you played?
I've only played up until the part where you go into the future.
Freaking beat it! I beat it.
It's a great game. It really is a fantastic game.
I beat an RPG that was not Quest 64.
That speaks volumes for how good it is.
Yeah, because I'm not, I have very little attention spans with RPGs anymore.
You know, I gotta wonder, was anybody clamoring for a sequel to Final Fantasy 13? Really?
No, they're just so freaking obsessed with their own work.
Or does Square want to be like, okay, we fucked up.
We like
Let's
this one.
Let's unfuck it by making another game.
Oh, like the Hulk.
The Hulk?
Yeah, the Hulk, the Incredible Hulk movie came out, and like a week later, they announced they were making another one. But it wasn't a sequel; it was a remake of the one that they just released.
I don't remember that. I do not remember that at all.
You're a towel. Was that the Hulk?
What the fuck is this thing? It's fucking weird.
It's your mom.
We are 45 minutes in. We need to move on to the next topic.
Oh, crap.
It's almost midnight. The 3DS will launch on March 27th at in the United States at a price point of $250. This price point, the entire world claimed that it was too expensive in 2004 when the PlayStation Portable launched at $250. Is it still too expensive in 2011 at the launch with the 3DS?
I don't know. I still think it's kind of gimmicky.
I think it's fairly gimmicky too. And from what I've been hearing from people who've been playing the thing in Japan, they've been getting headaches from extended play.
Yeah. Which I mean, you get headaches
like 30
from doing
minutes
anything.
Extended play.
Virtual Boy.
I don't know.
And
I don't know.
They did do that stuff with the Virtual Boy. People played for 30 minutes. They got headaches.
Mm-hmm.
The Virtual Boy.
They're using once again. Technology that's just not completely there yet, and they're Nintendo, so they can get away with it
because they did the Wii and it prints money.
Yeah,
but what do you think? Would you pay $250 for it?
I'd rather pay that much money for a Fondu set.
There you go. I think it's too expensive.
That was a quote of Big Timmy, Timmy San, when he turned 18 and we offered to take him to a strip club, and I said, yeah, you know, if you go to a strip club, expect to spend well over $100 between tips and admittance and drinks. And he was high at the time, and his response was, I'd rather spend that much money on a fondue set.
I don't have a pen on me.
You have a penis on you.
I do not have a pen. We need to grab a pen.
Why? To write down that awesome
fondue
quote.
Set.
You actually want to buy a fondue set?
We're going to title the episode.
We're going to title the episode Fondue Set.
Wow. That speaks volumes.
Okay. I also think $250 is a little too expensive for this. I thought $300, when they announced the price at $300 in Japan, and that translated to $300 in US. I have no idea what that is in Japanese. What is it? Yen?
Yeah, $250 is about maybe 300 yen.
Well,
maybe
it's,
less.
It's whatever it is in yen translates
it, 30,000.
$300 in US.
Wait, 300 US dollars? That would be.
I have no idea what that would be in yen.
That would be like 35,000 yen.
Whatever that is in yen, they said $300, and I'm like, that's way too fucking expensive. The people that could get that, they just go buy a PlayStation 3. They could buy a Wii and several
games. They could
games.
Buy that, get a propane generator, put it in a red riot in a radio flyer wagon, put the PlayStation 3 in it, and get a small flat screen TV and mount it to their wrist, and get like a nice little wrist brace and mount the controller to that, and walk around carrying this whole thing behind them, and they'd look retarded.
I think this brand loyalty is not going to save the Nintendo 3DS from this. I think that price point is going to hurt pre-sales.
Mm-hmm.
I think people are going to be like, that's too expensive. I could get a Wii brand new for that with a brand new video
people,
game.
Honest question, how many people have you ever seen you own a Virtual Boy?
I've met a couple, but they were few and far between.
I have met one.
I've only ever seen one at a series.
I met one, and it was actually an apartment with five people living there. So that's technically one-fifth of... And I only knew one of them, so it was like one-fifth of a Virtual Boy that I've ever seen.
I can't believe it was a system.
Like, I know.
I thought it was just like one of those things that like you see at an arcade or you see at a store. And I was like, look here. Like, they made games for that thing?
I love watching Keith Apicary walk around with one strap to his head, though. That's funny.
Are they even worth buying
as collectibles now?
They do have the Wario World game for Virtual Boy.
They had a Wario game for the platform.
It was actually supposed to be like really good. Except, as the nerd said, it's an awesome game, except for one fact. It's for Virtual Boy.
Yeah.
I would play it.
Either that is Nintendo's biggest mistake, or lending their license to Philips is Nintendo's biggest mistake. Because
PlayStation.
No, it's the latter.
Giving their license to Philips resulted in three horrendously bad Zelda games.
Oh,
Wand of Gamelon,
my boy,
Faces of
Squad-a-la.
Evil, and. I can't remember the name of the third one.
What would YouTube be without those games?
I don't know. One of them
a bunch of political discourse.
One of them was a top-down game where you played as Zelda.
That was your mom.
One of them you played as Zelda finding Link. Whoever thought that was a good idea?
I don't know. They made Mario's Missing. That game was kind of...
Yeah, but Mario is Missing, you got to play as Luigi. And
yeah, that's fine. He deserves a game. You know, he's always...
What about that Mario the Inside Story? Wow.
Where you play
what
as Bowser?
The one where you go inside Bowser?
Yeah, Bowser eats, Mario and Luigi, and half of it is Bowser playing, and the other half is Mario and Luigi
so
inside
it's
Bowser.
Like play on words. Like inside
yeah,
story.
That's kind of...
Yeah, I heard that was actually a decent game, though.
If not a little fetishistic, but...
Yeah, a little fetishistic, yes, but I
is
heard
that even
it was
a word?
Fun.
Fetishistic?
I don't know. But
weird.
I heard that game was actually decent. Okay, if you buy Portal on the PlayStation 3, you will get
Tasty Pudding.
You will get the PC version of it for free. The PlayStation 3 version will have cross-platform chat with the PC version. And it will also be able to play games with people who play it on the PC, which ultimately means the best version of this game will be on PC or PlayStation 3. If you get the Xbox 360, you don't get the PC version of it. You do not get the cross-platform play. And chat with the other two, with the other console or whatever, the other platform. And I'm looking forward to Portal 2. I wish they would give us Half-Life 2 Episode 3 before they give us Portal 2, but I know that's not going to happen.
I like Portal better anyway. Although, actually, as far as first-person shooters go, I do really enjoy Half-Life.
You never finished it.
I've played about 3 hours of Half-Life anything over the course of my life, but... For the little bit that I did was exposed to it, I enjoyed it.
I was kind of surprised that you enjoyed it, honestly.
Well, I mean, the mechanics are decent. It's old school enough that I can kind of get into it.
Have you played Portal D-Pad?
Yeah, I played through Portal.
You looking forward to Portal 2?
Yeah, I don't know.
I actually, that's one of the...
I don't know really what else they could do with Portal. I mean, it's a
that's
puzzle
one of the
game,
dozen...
You know, so I guess they could make more complex
have you seen...
puzzles.
Have you seen the, they have four colors of portals now, and...
No.
Yeah.
Oh, how do you keep your track of everything?
Because you have
orange,
two
blue,
people playing
gray,
at the same
taupe.
Time.
And what was the last one?
Taupe.
Tope, but as in it, Topaz?
Something like that.
It's because you have two people playing at the same time. You get co-op portal.
Okay, that's cool.
Yeah. Co-op portal.
And then there's something to do with
co-op portal.
Throwing callers through portals, and I don't remember what it was.
But you can shoot a portal through a portal?
Yeah, I always wish that you
that's
could
like
do that.
Art.
Yeah, you can't. I don't know. Could you shoot a portal through a portal?
No, you couldn't
portal?
Do that, and that always bugged me.
In,
you could peek your head through it just enough that your gun is sticking out the other end, but you can't actually shoot. Because if you hit where a portal is, it'll just replace the portal.
Speaking of shooting a portal through a portal, have you ever played Darksiders Wrath of War?
No, I watched you play it.
It's very, very much like God of War and Zelda had a fucked up with her baby.
Right, it's like puzzles. God of War with puzzles.
Yeah. Good puzzles. Right. It's not as good as God of War. It's not as good as Zelda. But it does everything pretty damn well still. And at the end, you get basically a portal gun. And some of the puzzles do involve shooting portals through portals.
Nice.
It's a cool little game. I really enjoyed it.
Was it a little game? Like is it a...
Well, I say little game, but it's like 20 hours.
Right. Because I remember
Zelda
Portal
length.
Was like 4 hours of gameplay.
It's like Zelda length.
I gotcha.
And I really
Are
enjoyed it.
Are we talking Ocarina of Time length and or Majora's Mask?
They actually used the portal gun for a really cool boss fight. Like an actual boss fight. Like you have to slash him with... But what it was you had to figure out a way to launch yourself into the air and glide down. So you can attack a giant golem in the head.
Right.
And
so it's just like fighting GLaDOS.
It's very different from fighting GLaDOS. Because you actually use your sword and hack and slash him. But you have to use the portal gun to get to his face.
Folks, I got to get to bed and I gotta go grab my laundry before I get to bed. But let me just say this much in case you guys wrap up before I get back upstairs. Portal 1 is one of the very few, maybe dozen or two dozen, of the few games that I've ever actually had the pleasure of playing all the way through and enjoyed it enough to beat. Warmly recommended, and anything, any sequel, any spin-off to such a series as good as Portal is greatly warranted, no matter how much it sucks, it should exist. So, we'll find out. I'll be right back.
Adios.
Probably.
Well, I'm going to wind up getting Portal 2, and I'll get it for my PlayStation 3, and then I'll get the PC version of it and be able to play that as well. But...
See, I think two-player co-op, that's cool and all.
That's
cool
what I'm really looking
forward
to.
Having to work together to figure out portals and everything, and figure out puzzles and all. Because then, like, it would open up all this room for communication and say, like, okay, well, hey... Well, we gotta do this, to see how two minds work together.
Yeah.
But what I want to see is two-player versus.
I don't know if it would have versus. I do not know.
Yeah, obviously it wouldn't, cool, because you can't actually fight anything in Portal.
To
but if you had...
And be like, D-Pad, get your ass over here, we're playing Portal. it better fucking have split-screen. If it does not have split-screen, I'm gonna be pissed. Well, you know? That's something I'm missing.
Did you say it was 360?
PS3, 360 PC. Okay. Gabe Newell, after talking shit about the PlayStation 3 in the past and saying he doesn't want to develop for it, actually showed up on Sony's stage and said, the best version of Portal will be for the PlayStation 3. He said that on stage.
Well, I'm going to have a PlayStation 3, so. And you have a PlayStation 3, so that's not good.
Yeah, do you have yours online?
Yeah, I got it online. I haven't set up a
account.
Yeah.
But let me know when you do. I'm going to try to get the internet working again here. Because I don't know what the fuck happened to the internet, but the wireless, it's not sending a wireless signal for the wireless internet. So I can't get my PlayStation Portable online, or my PlayStation 3 online, which is a large part of the reason why I've been playing my PSP so much lately, and Crisis Core on. And that's it. I'm really enjoying that game, by the way. Crisis Core Final Fantasy VII. You play as Zack, it's got an action battle system instead of a turn-based one, so it's not Gameplay wise, it's not like Final Fantasy VII. But yeah, we'll wrap it up here pretty quick. But other than that, you get
I am 8 to 16 months old. Ooh, yum! Brightly colored, candy looking. I think I'll cram it down my esophagus. Proceed.
Is this something Sebastian did?
David Spade. Close. They kind of looked similar.
What was I saying?
Sebastian looks like a young David Spade.
Yeah. You were talking about Crisis Core.
Oh, yeah. It's got an action battle system, so you, like, hack and slash your way through the battles, which is...
Can you still level up?
Yes, you still level up. But it all depends upon this really weird thing called the digital mind wave. That I was like, fucking digital mind waves. How does that work? Fucking magnets and shit.
How do they work?
That's what I was referencing. Fucking magnet, man.
How does he work?
Yeah, how does he work? I texted you that earlier this week.
Yeah, I got that.
He's a stockbroker.
Alright, is that our last topic?
Yes, that's our last topic. So you guys want to sign off for this week?
Yeah, we'd like to stick around a little bit longer, but let's depart for the week.
So tell people goodbye.
Bye, folks. We will see you on the following Sunday.
So tell the people goodbye, D-Pad.
Take it easy, USA and
the world.
Other parts of Europe. Various
xenophobes.
Also, only people in the United States and Europe can listen to us.
Hey, we're going global here, man. We're on the World Wide Web.
Fuck them Canadians. They can't listen to us.
Oh, and fuck those Amish guys for not listening to us. And all the deaf people out there who listen to us.
Yeah, what up with that?
We don't like our deaf
monocle wearing
the deaf families.
Yeah, the deaf people are a bunch of monocle wearing. Okay, we gotta go. Anyway, this is
what we can make fun of deaf people all we want.
Yeah, because they can't hear.
What are they gonna do? Listen.
Reminds me of an episode of My Name Is Earl where they were robbing a deaf person and Randy just leans the ladder to climb up through her window against the window and then starts climbing it and it crashes through the window and breaks it. And then the other guy kicks in the door like, I love deaf people! And they're in her bedroom, and of course she can't hear.
That's horrible.
It was great, though. Anyway, this has been another edition of Press the Action Button podcast on digital-delirium.com. I am your host, Joystick, and we will talk to you guys next week.
Around the lake tonight, around